Welcome back, Geekmas continues, and today's video is all about eyeshadow palettes that I wish I had used more this year, but I definitely plan on using them more. These will probably be palettes that will show up in Project Level Up or future Shop My Stash, and I'm pretty excited to share them with you. If you are new, I hope you'll subscribe. It is Geekmas, so daily videos in December. If you love eyeshadow palettes, I just posted my palette collection videos. Check those out. Everything is in the Geekmas playlist that I'm uploading this month, and let's get started. Okay, I have a basket full of palettes that I wish I had used more this year. So let's just go ahead and start with these two from Melt Cosmetics. They are my only Melt Cosmetics palettes. I do love them. The Melt formula is great. These have just kind of been forgotten about, which is sad, and it's my own fault. Gemini 2, beautiful rosy tones, and the greens. Hardly used it this year, which is really, really silly. And then the She's in Parties, which this I bought at the beginning of this year when they had a sale, I think, or maybe I got it Black Friday last year. I don't know. It's stunning. It's a palette I've wanted for a very long time. I feel like this is a good one that could be in Project Level Up. Now, some of these are larger palettes like this one. Now, this one I don't think I'd put in Project Level Up because I currently have the Nomad Ghost Town USA palette in Project Level Up, and it's kind of a lot of eyeshadows. I think I'm going to stick to like small to medium sized palettes for that project, but I need to do some other Shop My Stash. I have just like fallen off doing Shopping My Stash this year. I've just been kind of focusing on Project Pan stuff, and then in the middle I just kind of use whatever else I feel like that day, which is okay too, but I have a large palette collection, so I need to figure something out. The Tarte Man Eater though, I bought this last year and I really, really like it, and I hardly used it this year, which is really, really sad because it's a very good palette. I am very impressed with that formula. Here's an older palette that I kind of forgot about until I was filming my palette collection videos, the Venice Fling by Bailey Sarian. And also I was reminded of this because Bailey is now collabing with Melt Cosmetics, and I do want that palette. It looks amazing. And like I just said, I love the Melt formula. So that kind of reminded me of this one and my Melt Cosmetics palettes. This is a really good palette that I don't really know why I haven't used it that much, other than I have a lot of palettes. This is the Huda Beauty Empowered palette. Beautiful warm tones, some purples, very smooth pigmented formula. It's really, really nice. Now, here's one I really regret not using more because you guys have told me that the Patrick Ta palettes tend to go bad rather quickly, which is unfortunate. So this is the Major Dimension Rose 2. I don't have anything bad to say about it. I really, really like it, but it's very expensive. So especially if it's going to go bad, that's not good. So that's on my list. These two from ColourPop, I kind of forgot about until I was filming the palette collection videos. This is the Sage the Day, which is gorgeous green tones and brown tones. This is beautiful. I feel like that would be a good one for Level Up also. And Petals on Point, which is a more taupey kind of pink. There's a couple like this light blue, if you can see it. It's really, really nice. I don't know what to tell you guys. I should be using these palettes. Next up, the Profusion Meadow palette. This is really good, and it's only $5. Fantastic. Love it. I mean, the packaging is kind of cheap, but that's fine because the eyeshadows are good and it's inexpensive. So this one, definitely got to use this one soon too. Ooh, I'm seeing Christmas colors here. Maybe I should be pulling that out for later this month. All right, I got some thoughts. In general, I would say I tend to neglect single eyeshadows, which is sad. I have a lot if you saw that palette collection video. And so the Lethal Cosmetics, I have two of these Lethal Cosmetics palettes. They are so good and I just kind of forget about them, just like all my other single shadows, which is really, really sad. So again, this is one maybe for Level Up. We shall see. I'm still on Level 2 for that project. I keep mentioning Project Level Up because that's currently the only project I'm doing that is eyeshadow palette focused. Other than that, I don't really tend to put eyeshadow palettes in projects. I don't do pan that palette anymore. I don't do pan those eyeshadows because I would rather focus on like using all of my palettes instead of trying to like pan one or pan a few eyeshadows here and there. I don't want to do that. This palette I bought a few months ago, and it is the Natasha Denona Yucca palette. I've only used it like 3 times since I got it, so I've been really focused on my other Natasha Denona palettes this year, though. I will be doing another video, by the way, where I'm going to talk about my most used eyeshadow palettes this year. I've been planning that. And I can go ahead and tell you that my Natasha Denona palettes, other than this one and maybe like 2 others, are like my most used this year. I really try to focus on them because A, I love them, and B, they're expensive. So anyway, Yucca, it's gorgeous. Gotta get more use on it though. Here's another ColourPop palette that I kind of forgot about until I was filming that collection video. It's like when you pull everything out, you're like, oh, this got hidden over here. This is the Fairy Well, which is a beautiful taupe color story. Really, really nice. Gorgeous formula. Got nothing bad to say about it. Here is an older palette that I kind of forgot about. The reason that I forget about this one, though, is because I feel like this is a companion palette. It is the Urban Decay Stoned Vibes. And for me, I don't love it on its own, but I like it, like using the shimmers to top other metallics from other palettes. So the problem is, yeah, it's not a standalone palette for me. So I just kind of tend to forget about it, which is sad because the shades in here are amazing. And also, can we talk about this packaging? I might say this is like the most beautiful eyeshadow palette like packaging I have in my collection. It's gorgeous. Here's one that I've hardly used, and I bought this palette at the beginning of the year, the Beauty Bay Dark Fantasy palette. It's lovely. The Beauty Bay formula is great. I really like it. I do have several others. And yeah, I mean, you got some neutrals, you got a lot of smoky tones, you got some like deeper, colorful shades. This would have been perfect for like Halloween time, but clearly I, forgot about it then too. Although I did mention it in a best fall palettes video, and then I proceeded to forget to use it. So that's my own fault. And then this is one that Urban Decay also, I really like Naked Honey. And the reason I know why I haven't, whoops. The reason why I haven't used this is that I have a lot of warm-toned eyeshadows in my collection. Granted, I tend to wear warm tones like the most over anything else, over colorful shades, over cool tones. So this is a palette I should be reaching for because it's definitely something like an everyday look for me. So maybe this is a good one for Level Up also. We'll see. All right, and then I have two from Pat McGrath in here, but honestly, I should use all my Pat McGrath palettes more because they are so expensive. This is Divine Rose 1. I bought this a few months ago, only used it a couple of times, but it's gorgeous. I was so impressed. It looks kind of like blah and boring in the pan, which is why I never bought it. But there was a pretty good sale. I think it was 40% off when I bought this, and I was like, you know what? I've been wanting it. Now that I have it, I can tell you it's one of my favorites, but now I need to use it more. So, And then last up, Divine Rose 2. This one, I think I get thrown off by this bright pink because I open it and that's like the first thing that I see. And I'm like, eh, I don't feel like wearing bright pink eyeshadow. But there's so many other shades that are like taupey and rose toned, and then you've got a gold. So I think I need to just like cover this up. 'Cause yeah, when you cover that shade, I don't know, it just makes a lot more sense to me. And I like hot pink eyeshadow. It's just not something I want to wear a lot. So I don't know. Yeah, now when I do this, I'm like, oh, that's like a much more suitable for me color story. So yeah, that shade is just kind of throwing me off. I don't even think I've ever used this shade. Again, what am I doing with my life? I need to be using this. I need to be using my other palettes. So I could have included probably a lot more palettes in this video, but I decided to keep it somewhat simple. But out of these, I think the ones that I would definitely want to put in Level Up are maybe the Divine Rose palettes, the Melt Cosmetics, and I don't know, maybe some of those ColourPop palettes, but some of the larger ones, like the Beauty Bay palette and the Tarte Maneater, those I need to just figure out like a good shop my stash way to do that. So I need to come up with a new palette rotation. We'll see what I come up with. Like I said, I've just kind of not really been doing a Shop My Stash for a while, but is what it is. But that is it for this video. Let us know, do you also have eyeshadow palettes that you've neglected this year? Hopefully I'm not the only one. If you are new, I hope you'll subscribe. Check out the eyeshadow palette playlist. There's a ton of palette videos there. Geekmas, like I said, it's happening. So check out the Geekmas playlist to catch up on the other videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a great day.